The richest soil in the world is found on the forest floor, and it's important that you have that exact same living soil profile in your own garden. The reason the forest floor's soil is so rich is because of all of this organic matter. Every single fall, the leaves come off the trees and they fall on the ground. They break down over 12 months' time, they become compost. Then 12 months later, what happens? More leaves fall. This repeats itself every single year. It's important to keep that concept in mind because that's exactly what we're going to create in your own garden, and we'll start with preparing a brand new bed. Before we start talking about how to prepare a brand new bed, I want to explain what I mean by a living soil profile. I'm talking about a thing called mycorrhizae. You've probably heard about it, but maybe don't know quite what it does. It's simple. They're living organisms in the soil. What they do is they break down organic matter. Then they make that matter available to the plants, also fertilizers that you put in. They're very important. How do they do this? It's easy. If this is your plant's roots, the mycorrhizae come in, they attach themselves to the roots. They put out tendrils that go out into the soil. They make all that food available by breaking it down. They bring it back into your plants. They receive sugars in exchange for that. That's why it's called a symbiotic relationship. So creating that living soil profile with all those living beneficial mycorrhizae and beneficial fungus is what's important. Now notice I said organic matter. That's a key. So when you're doing a brand new bed, the first thing you're gonna do is add organic matter. The way you do this is simple. About 2 to 3 months before you want to plant, I do this in the winter a lot because I know I want to plant in spring, go ahead and find your new bed, lay it out, and start turning it over. Use a shovel, use a rototiller. If you've got a tractor, you can use a subsoiler. Whatever you have will work just fine. And you start to turn it, and then what I want you to do is take some compost. In our case, we have horses, so I've got good composted horse manure. But you can make your own compost. Jackson and Perkins carries a lot of great composters, and that's a really good way to get compost. Go ahead and lay that on there, about 2 or 3 inches deep. Work it into the soil. Continue to work it all through the entire soil and do the entire bed, not just the areas that you're gonna plant. Continue to work it in, again, 2 to 3 months ahead of time. Then the last thing you're gonna do is take a mycorrhizal drench. You can find them in almost any garden center. I'm gonna use a watering can, you can use a hose end sprayer, whatever works for you, and go ahead and get that mycorrhizal drench, because that's gonna put mycorrhizae in the soil and jumpstart your living soil profile. So that's how you do a brand new bed, which is fairly easy. But what about an existing bed where you've already got plants? Well, there's a method for that as well. In an existing bed where I've already got plants like my galra and my echinacea, I can't dig up the entire bed, but I still have to get organic matter in the ground for those mycorrhizae to feed off of. And there's a way to do this, and you're gonna need 3 things. 1, worm castings, your mycorrhizal drench, and believe it or not, a bulb auger. The first step to getting this organic matter in the ground is to take a bulb auger. And you can see how easy that works. About every 2 or 3 feet, I'm gonna basically drill myself a hole. And I'm gonna do that throughout the entire garden. Then I'm gonna take my worm castings, and I'm gonna basically drop them in the holes and fill them up, is what you wanna do. Then when you're done with that, go ahead and cover your holes up. I'm gonna do this throughout the entire bed, making sure I stay away from the root zones of all the plants that I've got already existing in the garden. That's how I can get organic matter in this garden without disturbing the existing plants. The last step is just like the other one. I'm gonna take my mycorrhizal drench and I'm gonna start to spread it all throughout the garden. Now that we've jump-started a living soil profile, either in a brand new bed or existing bed, it's important we continue to build that year after year after year so that all those mycorrhizae continue to have organic matter to feed off of. To figure out how to do this, let's go back to the forest floor analogy. Remember when in the beginning when I said that the leaves fall on the forest floor, then they break down over 12 months and become compost? Here's an important thing to remember. That fresh organic material, be it leaves, be it fresh mulch that you put on your garden, needs nitrogen to break down. If you put it on bare soil, it's gonna pull nitrogen from the soil and from your plants. That's why I want you to do something called the two-layered mulch approach when you mulch in spring every single year. The first mulch you're gonna put down layer is gonna be compost. This is your nitrogen-producing layer. You put it on the bare soil. It's then the buffer between it and your next layer, which is your fresh hardwood mulch, which is your nitrogen-taking layer. What will happen over 12 months now is this continues to break down. This actually then becomes your nitrogen producing layer when the fresh hardwood mulch is decomposed. And in fact, if you look in my bed right here, this is this year's mulch that I put down in spring. When I go down, this is last year's mulch, which is now compost. To create that living soil profile and maintain it all year long, just think of the forest floor. Now, I realize all this preparation up front seems like a lot of work. Wouldn't it be easier to just dig the holes and amend them? Well, it is extra work up front. I won't kid you about that. But think about this. If I step outside my bed here, and look, I can barely get a shovel into this soil. But I prepare this entire bed, and here, it slips right in, making digging a lot easier, and I can plant anywhere without having to worry about amending the bed. That's why I want you to think of the entire bed. For Jackson and Perkins, this is Paul Zimmerman, and thanks for joining us in the garden.